It's funny when you look back and see how little you really knew. Back then, all I ever tried to do was move forward. But it was more like a crooked, squiggly line, moving all over the place with my head down. And every time I looked up, there was always someone staring right back at me, someone who knew me better than I did. I don't know if that's saying much, being that I didn't have the slightest idea of who I was or what my purpose in life could be. I guess that's one of the perks of being young, discovering who you are and making a path in life. That's one of the perks of being young. That and being a complete fucking dumbass. It was tough being young. At least I thought it was.
Okay, what do you got? You might want to decide a little faster. It's starting to get kind of late.
Oh, I'll drag this out till morning if I have to.
Hey, that's fine with me, just as long as you go for another beer run.
How's that working out for you?
What?
Being a good-for-nothing drunk piece of shit. You smell like a distillery.
Well, I cut back on the liquor now. I only drink beer.
Sure. All right, but before I go, let's make this a little interesting. I mean, you know, this really isn't worth anything to me. So why don't we double the stakes? Winner gets the pot and an extra $1,000.
Gee, Jimmy, I really don't have $1,000 on you.
Oh, I know you don't, but I do. So if you win, you get an extra $1,000, and if you lose, you can just pay me later.
Think about what you can do with that money, Fred. Be able to upgrade back to liquor. Maybe even buy something better than that cheap-ass vodka that comes in a plastic bottle.
I don't drink liquor anymore.
Sure. It's like you don't smoke cigarettes.
You think I can have one, Jimmy? Alright. You got yourself a deal. Let's see what you got.
Two pair.
Full house. Looks like I win. Better pay up, Jimmy. What the hell, man?
You know, there's a slither of a chance that you won fair and square. But your track record suggests that you probably cheated.
No, I wouldn't do that. To you.
You wouldn't do that to me. I don't know if you'd do that to me, and I don't really care, because what I care is what I think, and what I think is you cheated.
What the fuck, Jimmy?
You have three options. Well, two in my opinion, but there is that third option. One, I end your pathetic, useless existence right here, right now.
Well, what if someone calls the cops?
You don't have to worry about that. You'll be dead. Option two, I find you, let's say, 2 weeks from Friday night, without my money, and I do the job then. And then there's option number three, where you pay me by the deadline.
I don't know about any of this.
You never know anything, Fred.
All right, option three, just put away the gun, all right?
No problem.
So I hear you've been going back to that piss pond you call a bar every night. Getting shit-faced. Every night. Someone even said that you talk like there's somebody else there, but you know what? There's nobody there.
No, that's not true.
Sure. Just a normal person like everybody else. You know, you never should have quit working for me, Fred. Could have been something. Could have made something of yourself. Shoot, you could even be where I'm at right now.
Oh, yeah. Nah. What the hell exactly is that, Jimmy?
For bigger and better things.
I used to know a guy.
I don't know anybody.
I used to know a guy. I don't remember his name. He was like 70, 80 years old.
Eddie.
Well, Eddie, he didn't own any nice clothes. You know, he dressed like shit. But his hair. His hair was really nice. This shiny, greased back.
Is there a point to this story?
I mean, what is this? Do I need a haircut?
What the hell?
What this is a story. And I was gonna finish the story by telling you that how in the end, it doesn't even matter.
Of course it matters. I'm a professional.
I'm professional.
Come on, Fred, seriously. You and I know all too well that you have a lot to prove.
Starting after today, you can start telling the story about Fred and how he proved himself.
Better than the stories I'm usually telling about you.
Nice kitchen.
Jimmy.
So you decide which option to go with?
Yeah, I did. How about option 4, where you put that gun away and I beat the shit out of you?
You're kidding, right? All right, Fred.
Just no satisfaction in fighting a guy like you, Fred. I just feel sorry for you. But you do owe me. I didn't want it to end like this.
Alright, fuck! I got the money, alright? I have it.
Really?
Yeah, I had a really rough night last night.
Yeah, I can see that.
And I stashed it in the middle of the desert somewhere, down south.
I don't believe any of that. But you do amuse me. You know, the desert is a good place to bury a corpse. You got one more chance, Fred.
Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling. The lemon time. But I kiss your little sister. Oh, my darling, Clementine. To heaven, but we're all still alive. Oh, fuck it.
You awake? Yeah, I figured if I told you Friday, I wouldn't find you till Saturday. You really ought to stop drinking so much.
Yo, speaking of drinking, I think you can pull over real quick, man.
Anyway, that's pretty embarrassing. Well, good luck keeping it up, Phil. My friend Phil, man, he just can't fix anything. Toilet clogs, he just leaves it. You're not that kind of person, I hope.
Nah, in fact, I don't get the toilet clogged in the first place.
So you're not full of shit, huh? Awesome. You like the house?
Yeah, it's a nice backyard.
So what, you only like the yard, not the rest of the house?
It's a nice house.
You are full of shit. Yeah, I'm selling it in 2 weeks, because I'm moving on up.
Like the Jeffersons moving on up?
Yeah, like the Jeffersons.
Well, that's an aspect I want to get more familiar with, you know what I mean?
Well, let me tell you, you're friends with Action McJackson. You'll finally get your piece of the pie. I put it in lunchbox so it wouldn't look suspicious.
Nothing suspicious about a man carrying a lunchbox.
A man? You're still a boy.
You're starting a little late today, aren't you?
Shut up.
I will as soon as you stop talking to me.
Well, after tonight, I just may.
Oh, really? And why is that?
Because after today, I will have some money.
So, that's what this is all about. Money.
After today, I'll have some.
Huh. Yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to talk to you about. Today.
Why would I tell myself what I'm doing today?
I don't know. Why don't you tell me? You're the one that's fucking crazy. And then again, if you did tell me, that might make you even crazier. Tell me. You plan on doing it anyways.
Alright. So I gotta get some money from A, take it to B to get C, and take C back to A.
Wow. You explained that so awesomely that I didn't even understand it. You think you could dumb it down for someone like myself? Can understand, please?
So a couple weeks ago, I met this porn star named Mickey McMichael.
Is that his porn name?
Actually, his porn name is Action McJackson.
I like his real name better.
Anyways, I find out that this guy, he's a real cokehead, and he wants to start some kind of partnership with me.
So where do you come in?
Well, I know another guy, and he's got the best deal in town. And that's why I got a lunchbox full of cash.
So, you're kind of like the middleman of this whole operation, right?
That's right, man. You gotta start digging this, Sly.
So, who's the dealer?
I don't know, some cowboy named Sergio, I think. I met him here.
Here? Okay, and exactly how much does this Mickey McMichael plan on buying?
I don't know the exact measurements and all that, but I know whatever it's gonna be a lot. So don't worry about it.
Right. I'm just kind of confused about what exactly.
Holy shit.
Hey there, stranger.
Howdy.
Got a cigarette?
I smoke cigarettes, but I don't buy them.
That's a shame.
So you walked all the way over here just for cigarettes?
It's not the only reason.
Well, it should be, because I'm leaving.
You don't even want to talk?
I was always told not to talk to strangers.
So the less you know, the better.
Well, that's just where we're different, because I don't trust strangers.
Not even me?
Especially the good-looking strangers.
I bet you don't get laid too often. What if I told you I'm not such a stranger? What if I told you I met you here before and I even said hi?
I think I'd remember something like that.
Do you remember picking a fight with a bunch of bikers and getting thrown out on your ass? Maybe you remember waking up covered in bruises in your underwear?
I woke up in a farm that night. I had cow shit all over me. You think that's funny?
I just think it's cute how you're so damn miserable all the time. I just want to make you smile.
Lady, there's got to be something to this.
There is, but I think you'll like it.
So, what's with the cowboy over there that keeps looking over at us?
I don't know. By some guy that gets lonely every night. Just like you.
So, you met me when I was real drunk.
Yep.
What did you think?
Same thing I'm thinking now.
And what are you thinking?
We should fuck. Too far from here for reasons I'd rather not talk about right now, if that's not a problem.
Where's the hotel?
Just south of here.
I'm going south.
Right.
It's gonna be a hell of a night.
You have no idea.
Dang.
Hey, listen, I got stuff to do, so I'm gonna have to make this quick.
Whatever. Can you help me with this? I have a hard time when I'm drunk.
Yeah, you don't seem very drunk. Am I gonna have to pay for this or something? Fuck?
Sorry, I don't fuck stupid assholes.
Oh, I was really looking forward to seeing that fine ass of yours.
Oh, god damn! Oh. You know you're not gonna get any ass from the ladies talking like that.
Yeah, I thought you seemed like the kind of guy that knows a lot about women.
Oh. You know, if it were up to me, I would smash your fucking head in the mirror and use the broken glass and cut off your nuts and shove them down your fucking throat. The glass and your nuts! Oh.
Wow, that was really poetic. Are you some kind of writer or something, man? That was good. Oh.
Can we leave or what?
Why are you on your ass?
You got the keys?
The keys. You're gonna act like a stupid child.
I'm just making sure this fucking guy doesn't get up again.
Well, I think you did a good job of that.
Yeah.
I must be the unluckiest person in the world.
So what am I supposed to do next?
You should know exactly what to do.
How about that bar you always go to? I think you're running a little late for your next drink.
Here I thought it was gonna be you at that fucking hotel, huh?
Do yourself a favor. Get yourself drunk.
New challenger.
Have you ever done this before?
Don't think so.
Boy. Who are you? What do you want?
Fucking tell him! Fuck!
Maybe you should fucking tell me.
I'm Fred. The guy you just shot. His name is Sergio, right? I met him at a bar not too long ago.
Sergio? Yeah. He used to work for me. You make enough mistakes, you have to pay the price.
Are you the boss?
Yeah, there are no leaders. You know, we all work for a common purpose. People around here, they call me Django. Some people even call me El Django.
Let's have a drink. And we don't get that many strangers around here. What'd you say your name was again?
Fred.
Fred. You like rum?
Of course you do.
You drink urine if it got too drunk. You know, I got this friend Guillermo. He can drink so much he gets drunk off his own urine.
What can I do for you, Fred?
I don't know. I came here in hopes of getting some drugs, but
I don't care anymore. I just want to go home, and I promise you, you will never hear from me again.
What kind of talk is that? You telling me you want to give up? I mean, what happened to all your determination? I mean, you must have been damn eager to end up in a place like this, of all places. And now you're scared and you want to quit? Quitting is a sign of weakness. Are you weak? Because I don't think you are. I think there's something about you that nobody knows anything about. How fast are you?
What?
You ever kill somebody?
No.
You ever want to kill somebody?
Not unless I have to.
See? You're not so different from us as you think. Me? I killed many people. One reason or another, I guess. Some no reason at all. Sadly, that's made me the man I am today. Nikinsky here, he's killed 12 men and 3 women. All of them fair fights. He's kind of what I call my protege. And you know something else? I've never heard the sound of this man's voice. So you ready?
Ready for what?
For Kinski. He's your challenger.
Kinski? I can't duel him. I'm drunk.
That's the best time to do it.
No, man. I'm telling you, there's no fucking way I'm gonna do it.
You said you'd kill somebody if you could. It's one bullet each. You both miss, match is over. Kinski, he never misses. And by the way, Kinski shoots from the hip, so I suggest you do the same.
Oh,
Who the hell are you anyway?
People call me Fred. But my real name, my birth name, is Slywise.
Slywise? What kind of a stupid fucking name is that?
Fucking good now.
it going, man?
You know, you should gotta watch out for cops around this area, man.
Can you just get out of here?
It's in the lunchbox.
Yeah. You wanna know what's in the lunchbox? You wanna see what's in this fucking lunchbox? Let's find out. Looks like more money that I've ever seen in my entire pathetic life.
From what I've heard, you don't care much for money. In fact, you don't care at all.
I don't?
You don't put money in lunchboxes. You put sandwiches. Hey man, hate to be a bother, but think I could have that sandwich?
You little fuck. You know how long I've been walking?
Lost a lot of blood. What are you doing with that?
Just gonna see how fast you are. I did cheat you in that poker game. So because of that, I give you one free shot. But you only get one, so you better make it count.
What?
Just do it, Jimmy.
Ah! I can't! I can't shoot you! You've been like a son to me. I don't want to die.
Yeah. And don't think of it as dying.
Oh God, my skull is pounding. Ah, oh, Jesus Christ, my fucking skull. Woo-hoo.
Mr. McMichael.
What the fuck? Oh, it's you. You scared the fuck out of me, man. What's up?
You alright?
I wish I could remember what the fuck I did last night. You ever had a blackout? All I know is that I woke up alone, I missed America's Next Hot Star, I pissed on myself, and overall, had a shitty night. You have fun? Ah. What the crap is this crap? What the fuck?
Something wrong?
I did not pay for this much.
You won't have to.
Oh, okay. And how'd you manage that?
I wouldn't worry about it too much.
This is fucking ridiculous. What the fuck am I supposed to do with all this crap?
Sell it.
Sell it? Do I like a fucking drug dealer to you? You know, thanks for the offer and all, but this is just way out of my league.
So what the fuck was all that shit you were feeding me earlier about the Jeffersons moving on up, piece of the pie? What the fuck was all that about?
I was just trying to motivate you, man. You know, nudge you along a little. We form a good partnership. You have the supply, I have the demand, you make a little extra cash, and I get to party for free.
I see. Well, let me know if you need any more.
Wait. Hey, a copy of my new movie. Street's on Tuesday, but you can have a copy for free today. Huh? Yeah, huh? You like that? Huh? Yeah, huh? Huh? Hey, fuck you, you ungrateful bastard!
It's funny when you look back and see how little you really knew. When did I commit myself to something so wrong? It was tough being young. At least I thought it was.